number one ball. Introducing in the ring at this time, weighing 239 pounds, Paul, Mr. Wonderful, Orndorff. And his partner, weighing 420 pounds, King Kong Bundy. Their opponents are accompanied by their manager, Mr. Fuji. At a total combined weight of 540 pounds, the ace cowboy Bob Orton and the magnificent Muraco.
Magnificent Muraco and ace cowboy Bob Orton certainly have a very important date come March 29th, Silverdome, Pontiac, Michigan, as they will step into the ring and face the K&M Connection.
Well, there's no doubt about that, Monsoon. Let me tell you something right now. They better save the energy they're going to need for that big show up Pontiac. And of course, we're talking about WrestleMania 3, and I hope they don't lose a lot more of that energy right here.
Let me ask you this, Mouth. Of all these celebrities that are going to be involved in WrestleMania 3, I would assume that Aretha Franklin is probably your favorite.
No, she's not. Mary Hart was my favorite because, after all, I think she might be related to me somewhere down the line.
And Alice Cooper would have been your second choice.
Oh, Alice Cooper. I promise, if I get my hands on Alice Cooper, Gorilla, oh, it's going to be all over for him. School's going to be
all over
for him.
For you.
Oh, no way, baby.
Very unusual tag team combination here in the form of Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and King Kong Bundy.
Very, very interesting matchup here. You know, I'm sure that Orndorff certainly is in awe of Muraco, and I think vice versa as well. But you have to give them credit right up here. These are the two, number one, number two, number three, number four, top guys in the business right now. No ams, ifs, or buts about it.
Well, very impressive credentials, of course, carried into the ring with the magnificent one, Don Muraco, former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, and a whole lot more.
You know something, too, girl? I feel so safe out here right now. On my left, I got Johnny V, and on my right, I got Mr. Fuji, baby. I feel great.
Let's not forget Mr. Fuji. He's watching the match here. Is there any way that Mr. Fuji could come down here and say a few words? I don't know if he would like to say a few words here.
Mr. Fuji, welcome to Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. This is a very unusual tag team matchup combination.
Thank you. You see my team, Orton, right now. He's doing something very devastating. Oh, no! Something cross-stubborn right there. I don't understand.
Didn't work out too well. Are you looking forward to your big date, March 29th, in the Silverdome?
Ah, yeah. Those pretty boys, my thing, gotta be prepared.
Thank you very much. You're a very devious person.
He's got it under control, baby.
Certainly wouldn't want to buy a used car for him.
You know, he alluded to the fact that Martel and Zink, pretty boys. Well, maybe they are compared to Bundy, or maybe they are compared
anybody's
to Orton
pretty compared to Bundy. Are
well,
you
wait
kidding?
A second. There's a list for every pot. I'm sure there's a woman out there in our TV audience out there that would love maybe to have a date, maybe a blind date. Sure, granted, with King Kong Bundy, but. Listen, there's a lift for every pot again, as I said earlier.
A lot of people think Bundy's the Clark Gable of the WWF, Gorilla.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, they do. You know what?
You mean he's dead?
Oh, cute.
Oh,
real cute.
Wait a minute now.
Look out. Orton hard into the turnbuckle. Bundy was about to go over the avalanche, but Orton, the ring technician that he is, realized he had to get out of there.
But you know who's missing tonight? Bobby the Brain Heenan, baby.
Bobby the Brain Heenan, obviously very conspicuous by his absence. Maybe he and Andre are reviewing some films.
You see Don Muraco going right at Bundy right there. And, of course, the partner of his coming in here at the moment, Paul Orndorff. Here's two of the greatest right here in the ring. Of course, a tag made here, entering Don Muraco, if you will. He has
would you like? Would both you guys like to express an opinion here to possibly 30 million people who will be viewing this program? Pick me a winner in the Silverdome, Andre against the Hulk.
You got to go with Andre, baby.
I would say Andre the Giant, no doubt about it, is going to be the new champion of the world.
Yeah, but you're saying that, but you're not giving me any logical reasons.
Logical reasons, as Don Muraco is kicking Orndorff here, and we're looking over the right ear of Fuji, would be...
Keep that cane out of there.
Strength, experience, balance, determination, and there's a little thing called he wants to be the champion. The guy already is the champion. There's only one way to go, Hogan, and that's south. Andre only has one way to go, and that's to be the champion. I don't know if you know what it is, psychology of life, but when you're aggressive in life, you get things. You find out what you want, you find out what it takes to get what you want, and the third thing is do it. And on the 29th, maybe, at the Pontiac Silverdome, that's what Andre the Giant's going to do.
Thank you for your very biased opinion. Muraco stepping right on the throat of Mr. Wonderful. Andre the Giant has a couple of things going against him in that big matchup, in my opinion.
Name of two of them.
Well, number one, he's got Bobby the Brain Heenan as his manager.
Name me one more.
Number two, in order for him to become champion, you have to, there's only two ways you can win it. You must make Hulk Hogan submit, which is highly unlikely. Hulk Hogan will never submit. So he only has one way, really, to win the title, and that's to pin Hulk Hogan.
Why would you say that he wouldn't give up? How do you know that the guy wouldn't give up?
Because he's got too much guts, intestinal fortitude, something neither one of you knows a great deal about.
Yeah, fine. Let me tell you something. Every painter knows when the picture's finished. Do you understand? And I think the Hulk Hogan picture is finished to put Gonzo.
Orton in a lot of trouble here. I'm sorry, Orndorff.
Mr. Wonderful's in a lot of trouble. I don't think he is in a lot of trouble.
You know what, Gorilla's all shook up now, JB. I'm telling you, man.
Tag made.
King Kong Bundy. Enter if you will.
Bundy unloading on Muraco. Irish whip into the corner. Here comes the avalanche.
Boom.
He nailed him with it.
Even Don Muraco was jolted by that. Even Don Muraco felt that impact.
Sucker punch from the outside by Orton kept Bundy from literally putting away Muraco.
Oh, look at that right hand.
Bobby Orton caught him with a haymaker.
And drops an elbow on him. And another one.
Covering.
Whoa.
About 20 feet up in the air, man.
Certainly did.
Tag made as Mr. Wonderful steps in and he's on fire. He's still going after Muraco. Irish whip coming up.
Oh, boy.
Oh, just about rammed his head into that. Look at this. Atomic drop. He nailed him with it. Down for the cover. Muraco in to make the save. That one was history.
Ooh. Man, it's a Pier 6 battle out there. I'd hate
it
to see
that. It certainly is.
Stay out of the way, referee of these guys.
Look at this. The cane. Fuji stuck the cane in there.
Oh!
He got go down. Orton with it. And Morocco's down.
Oh, Fuji, way to go.
Orndorff. Covering ace, he got it.
Oh, boy.
Woo! Things sort of turned around.
The devious one, is that what you call him? Now you know why he's the devious one.
Things often backfire when you try to do underhanded things, as they did right here for Mr. Fuji.
Here are your winners, the team of Paul, Mr. Wonderful, Orndorff, and King Kong Bundy.
Well, Mr. Fuji actually causing his team to lose. Would you not
Ladies
say that?
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please.
Let's go back and take a look. Fuji thought he was doing something good as he hands Muraco the cane, and now Muraco goes to ram it, and instead Orndorff ducks and nails the ace. Right over quickly, making the cover, referee turning around, shoulders are down, 1, 2, 3, I loved it.
Oh, I don't.
We'll be back.
Boy, things really...